with Gray, Nagelstadt and Jones in the front three. Here they go. We should be getting some goals tonight. So, starting with Chattanooga, we've got Adam Rinton in goal. Alex Grattan in number three in the back with Martinez, Stripling and Robson having a four at the back, three in the middle, three at the front. Three in the middle, McGrath, 33, Dixon, four, the captain, and Ian Cerro on the right side. And then they said Taylor Gray, Marks, Nagelstadt and Brett Jones up the front. So a good strong 3-3-4 formation there. Let's take a look at our friends in Syracuse. And here we are, of course, Peter Fuller needs their introduction, the head coach. And for Syracuse, they have... You get the notes. Robinson in the goal, Mackie Robinson number one in the goal. And then we've got Sean Russell, ex-CFC player in the back, Zachary Reynolds and Carl Neal, Maury and Moosey. And then up front, Marion McKinley, Joe Louis, Injay Fratt, I mentioned number 10, Michael Grafari, and in the middle, Caleb Jackson, and Kayo De Silva, also ex-CFC players. So some familiar names there, and plenty of friendly relationship between these players, because these guys see each other outside the game, and we know each other, looking forward to playing each other again, seeing if we can have a rerun of the last game in Syracuse here at Finley. So it's very similar. It was a nice day then, it was sunny and hot. This is tonight too. Sun's starting to go down over the hills, but it's still very clear and beautiful. We had a lot of storms earlier in the afternoon, they're all gone. I think we should get through the game tonight without any wave interruptions. I hope I'm wrong about that. And Syracuse ready to kick off. We will bring you every minute of this game, folks. And some interesting guests at halftime too. I'll tell you more about that later on. We're about to get going, so get your favourite beverage, get comfortable. Soccer is about to begin on 11 Sports. Hooligans banging the drums nice and loud through the entire game. Don't be alarmed by the noise, folks. That's quite normal for a CFC match. Chattanooga with a little early pressure, trying to keep Syracuse in their own half. Syracuse to throw on the far side. Syracuse being first to the ball. This is a good break. That's been Jay Quack. Trying to find Caleb Jackson in the middle. And that one goes out for a throw on the far side. Carl Newton able to keep it in for Syracuse. But a good press early on there from Syracuse. Underwood not taking any chances with Syracuse being rid of the press and playing the four at the back. That may change during the game, but right now that's the early formation. A little defensive, but not a bad thing. Good steal there. Alex McGrath coming through. He's got an attacker on him. Is he going to get away? He is. Spreads out to Brett Jones on the right wing. Now Brett Jones. Good feed to Cerro. Too long for Ian to catch that one. Out for a goal kick to Syracuse. Now tonight's calls of the match is Big Brothers and Big Sisters of Greater Chattanooga. I'll be interviewing one of their team members here at halftime. Tell a bit more about what they do, the good work their organisation does. Way back, keeps it in play just back to Reddington. A lot of pressure early on for Syracuse here. They're not hanging about. Good shot there, charged down. Chattanooga now, Taylor Gray breaking away. And set the graph off and pushed out by Sean Russell for the throw-in on the far side. Both teams keeping up quite a pace in the first few minutes of play. See if they can do that as the heat continues. So over Dixon, McGrath, one of the try. McGrath goes down, referee does give the foul check this way. Quickly taken to Taylor Gray by McGrath. Taylor Gray looking to bring it in across. He's got three on him. And Cerro, the defending, out for a corner. First corner of the game to Chattanooga FC. That's a Chick-fil-A corner. Cerro and McGrath, as always, over the corners. Out, Frankie Martinez going to take the throw. Martinez spreading it wide all the way out to Brett Jones. Brett's got company, he's trying to get the ball back. Goes down under a foul, referee says nope, just throwing. So here we are. Oh, and tonight's referee, Alexander Sergishkov. I'm saying that one right. He's been here before. Played a good game. Now Frankie Martinez with the break. Good save from Reddington. Martinez. Oh, and wow, Syracuse cannot capitalise on that break. Juan Louis just cannot get it. So Juan Louis cannot get that one in. Reddington stands up tall, pushing it back. With support from Martinez, and Louis cannot deliver the goods. Good early breaks, let's see that again. Some good early breaks here from Syracuse. Yeah, Frankie Martinez didn't quite get it, man. Into the great save. Syracuse continued to push. The early pressure, a little different from the game they played for here during the 11th. So it's good to see an exciting game in both teams going for it. Through the season, not too many injuries going on. We have a couple of the knocks here, Travis Ward out and Kevin Gonzalez, but just minor things. They'll be back again for the next game, which is in 2 weeks against Flower City Union. So the guys get a short break in the middle of July, and yeah, not too many concerns about injury, which is good to see, because a lot of teams do start picking up knocks and fatigue as we're about halfway through the Nice season at present. Having to retake that free kick. Strickland, Dixon, Martino knocking it around. Sorry, he's not pressing as much as he did initially. We'll wait for Chattanooga to give it away. Martinez getting that long ball for Brett Jones. Brett just can't keep it in. I think that went out, but referee didn't see it. Ball through to McGrath. McGrath with a touch. Nagelstadt fighting for it. Nagelstadt goes down and a foul given. Just at the top of the D. Great save from Robinson in the Syracuse goal there. Now a test for Syracuse defence. First real free kick of the night. See a little replay of that. So that ball, McGrath gets in. He gets his leg out, gets the stab, then Nagelstadt gets pushed over. 2-on-1, referee's like, that's a foul. So we've got Graf Nacero over the free kick. So at the top of the D, about 20 yards out. This would be a great chance for Chattanooga to take an early goal, especially with Robson with the sun in his eyes. The sun goes down. Ball set at 10 yards away, which is where it's supposed to be. Nagelstadt telling him to get back, and the referee's having to walk that one out the full 10 yards and go, yeah, you're too forward, guys, come back a bit. And with the magic spray to show him where it's stand. There we go. Does a yard make a difference, you ask? It can sometimes. The deflection off the wall of Nagelstadt's cross, back in by Tate Robertson. Syracuse pushing out again, and that one goes out for a Chattanooga throw. Right underneath the hooligans. Peter Gray gives the ball away, steals it back. McGrath, and McGrath is offside. The flag goes up on the near side. Free kick to Syracuse in their box. 10 minutes played, 0-0. Both teams attacking. Good soccer, that's good to watch. This is what we like about watching on 11 Sports, is great soccer. Sees a foul there. And that touch from McKinley. Is that a long ball, Taylor Gray, on the end of that one? Can't get inside. He's working hard over there with Kafari. Taylor Gray again gets it back. Can he get the cross in before he runs out of real estate? He cannot. Syracuse defending well. Space on there instead of the whole field, so it's a little hard to get much to happen if you stick to that side of the field, or the other side of the field, really. Chattanooga looking to spread out a bit further. We've got men open, we've got Robertson, and here we go. Robertson can't control it, it's a little bit too strong, gets the ball back, but I think gives a foul away. Yep, referee calls a foul that one on the Ninja Quack. But Brett Jones and Taylor Robson on this side totally unmarked, but they made a good break there. So, free kick to Syracuse. Zach Reynolds, number 5. Should take by number 13. I was looking at that by Michael Kafari. Long shot, and that is way off. A little optimistic, that one. Power to Silva. patient build up here. Trying to keep the ball in possession. She's rolled the plan all along. It's just to maintain possession, look up, wait for the gaps to come. Stay focused on something that's easy, you can repeat over and over and over. Get back in your comfort zone, that's what they're doing. Syracuse able to capitalise on that one. A long throw trying to run Nagelstadt. He's got short muscle all over him. I think that one, yep, that one popped out for a throw too. Midfield play here, both teams trying to get a break and able to get enough passes moving to make an attack at this point. Taking the pace of play has slowed down from the first few minutes, which was a bit frantic. Syracuse happy just to retain possession at this point. Those long balls, and Martinez cuts that one out again. Dixon trying to flip over to Nagelstadt. Nagelstadt going in on the keeper, but wasn't pushing too hard this point. Martha de Silva. Again, there's that long ball, just too long, and it runs all the way back to Reddington. This is more like a bit of ping pong at the moment. Comfortably. Not too hard on that one. Now we're going to try and get Taylor Gray off again using his speed, but that one doesn't quite go correct. Syracuse pick it up. Syracuse trying to get it back, and they've seen blue shirts all around them. Clearance, but to anybody. Maybe retain possession back to Martinez, probably back to Reddington. Oh. Looking up. Challenger again, focusing on possession here. So with a touch on, that's a nice touch to Brett Jones. Sarah returns the favour, Brett Jones with a cross, that goes out for a corner to Chattanooga on the near side. Chattanooga patiently waiting for their break and taking it and using it to put pressure on with a corner. This is a Chick-fil-A corner. Sarah and McGrath over the corner once again. Just see him down there behind the wall. For the long one, they've got everybody deep in the box. Nope, go short to McGrath. That one's back out. Away to Dixon, back to McGrath. McGrath gets the shot. Here it is. Wow, what a goal! What a great goal! Well, how about that for a great bit of play? All the way back, and then just there for the tap in. It's like Colin Stripling with the tape all the way back from the defence. Let's check that out again. Watch this replay. This goes all the way back, and you think that's nothing. Long ball to McGrath from these three. Puts it across. Thank you. Tap, tap in the back of the net. 1-0. Chattanooga FC. How about that? He's almost, was there asleep, but not really expecting that one to come back when the ball is played back to the midfield and then suddenly slip through a gap like that. Just a great 1-2 goal there. McGrath again, he's got Brett Jones open. Let's see what Chattanooga do with the next attack. Swings it in, keeper can't get hold of it, punches it out, goes right in front of Taylor Gray, and he can't get a foot on it. He runs out for a throw-in on the far side to Syracuse. That came off the keeper's hand. We'll see what the referee is giving out to Syracuse or CFC. That's giving it to Syracuse. Down the line, it's under control. Does it run out? And out for another Chattanooga FC corner. He bounces it off Sean Russell's foot. Showing his experience there, playing internationally all over Europe and South America. A lot of experience there in Ian Cerro. So it's a Chick-fil-A corner. It's Chattanooga, third one of the game. Chattanooga in a good place to turn the screw on Syracuse here. Short corner again. Here it goes. Give and go. Chipped back in. Can't find a Chattanooga head. Finds a Syracuse head. Dixon tries to get that back. And the long ball. Too long, and Martinez cleans up. Chattanooga playing a little more confidence, and Syracuse can't sit back. As we said in the keys today, using the wings, stretching Syracuse, who are still a little bit weary of that return flight for California, and just opens the gaps up. And Richard Dixon with almost a sniper's eye there to find that shot to pass to McGrath. And after that, it's all history. So 22 minutes played, Chattanooga one up halfway through the first half. Nice place to be in. Now Taylor Gray coming down the left wing. He's got support in the middle. Who's he got? Nice give and go there from Cerro. Chipped across. Brett Jones. Oh, crowd on their feet for a handball there, but I think it was an intentional one. And he runs out for the Chattanooga throw on the near side. Is it in there, in the box? And it's going to go in. No, good score. What a clearance off the line. Wow. Almost a flick from Cerro into the goal. And Caio da Silva, full stretch, using his height to keep that one out of the goal because it went over the keeper's head. Wow, watch that again. Look at this. This is, the keeper does not know where this is. And it's Cerro cannot, touch doesn't go strong enough, I guess. And da Silva clears it, but that would have been a great goal to put Chattanooga through up. Here we go again, the corner, Chick-fil-A corner. Agustat, Cerro, brings it down, he's got two on him. Goes into space, good turn, gets it across. Keeper touches it, doesn't clear it, still loose in the box. Syracuse get it away, quack with the ball, can he get away? Chattanooga keeping the pressure on not holding off. Now they've got that first goal, they really are energised. Take Robinson all the way up there from the defence, playing like an attacker to Nagelstadt. Syracuse get possession back. Trying to make something happen, but only gets as far as Frankie Martinez in the halfway line. Sam Jones combining again. Jones, Robertson to Dixon. Shannon Bird going back to passing drill. Keeping possession. Syracuse not really pressing him at this point. He should be coming out a little bit. And get possession back, but happy to watch Chattanooga pass the round, which suits Chattanooga very well. Let's flick on there, a little miscommunication with Cerro and Jones. That one runs out for a goal kick to Syracuse. For the referee, I think we're getting like that one. Taking it at the exact place where it should have been taken. A little bit too fast. But they're trying to get the advantage by going swiftly. Sarah in the box. Swings it in. Keeper can't hold it, but again gets a second chance and grabs it. Strat coming on in there, but under control. They are working this defence hard. Lucy and Russell are both really working hard with De Silva as well. Again, Chattanooga winning the ball back. Looking for a slot, finding a slot. Brett Jones goes in to take the shot. Bounces out, and a Chick-fil-A corner. The corners are coming thick and fast, folks. If you keep track of how many are at home, it's 5 or 6 now, and I'll have to keep track. The last 10 minutes, Chattanooga really pushing Syracuse back into their half very firmly. Right, it's again the Sarah McGrath combination. Let's see. Into the middle, it's Dixon, way back. Robertson. Cerro. It's all the way back to Martinez. Never. Too much use made of that corner, but trying to keep possession. Look for a different approach. That's a nice ball. McGrath sweeps it through to Brett Jones. Houston reads that one and steals it. And finds Quack. Syracuse the chance to get away. Super long ball there, a little bit too long. Keep possession. Nice turn there. Syracuse going in. Can I go for the shot? Good save from Gregson again. Number one is number one. Keeps it in play, I think. Yes, it's still in play. Out for the throw. Great play from Matt Gregson. He is really sharp tonight. See that again, that was really good goalkeeping. Watch this, good turn there. Bang, off his knees, gets the block in, very good save. And then grabs it off the byline, very good. Syracuse couldn't much of that. Corner, trying again for the long ball, and Redison grabs that one, says thank you, calms everything down a little bit. That was an excellent move there from Syracuse. Jackson, the attacker there, the ex-CFC player. Now here's Brett Jones with Moosey. one-on-one. What's he got? Can he get away from him? Both these guys, very experienced. And he can. Tate Robertson. Through the Cerro, tries to get the turn. And Kafari. Kafari gets it away. Nice play from Stripling there. Full of confidence tonight. Making Brett Jones run a lot tonight, but nothing came out of that one. A throw to Sarah Hughes in the 30th minute, 1-0 to Chattanooga FC. Goal in the 19th, tapping and Stripling. Again, Kafari getting it away. So he's just going to reset, see if they can get something happening. Kingley out to Quack back on the left wing here. He's going to come inside Robertson. Gets the shot in. Oh, great save. Look at that from Reading. Wow. That was first class goalkeeping. Loves that, shouting Alex's name, and just an excellent play. And as you know, Kevin Gonzalez has been keeping between the sticks the last couple of games. Now it's been, you know, on the bench, but he's still sharp as ever. That is really excellent goalkeeping. Dixon spreads it wide. McGrath. McGrath's got options. He's got Jones and Nagelstad ahead of him. Brett Jones, here he comes, trying to get the cross in. Can't get it past Lucia. Good play there. Now Quack again. McGrath on his tail. Trying to clean that one up. Sorry, he's not able to get the break they're looking for there. When they do break, they look dangerous, so Chattanooga have to not be overconfident here. Make sure they stay focused. Chattanooga to throw on the near side again. If you're enjoying the game, folks, don't forget to come down to a game at Finley Stadium. If you want to save a bit of money, go to cfctix.com and get an advance ticket, 10% off, and come see the action for yourself here on a Saturday night. The next chance you have to do that is August 23rd. We have a cup game here. Oh, the boys in blue are playing August 16th. They're away at Flower City, but if you want to come, see you next time, July 23rd at 7:30, and be part of the action here at Finley Stadium. Rick Hughes looking for the attack, slowing it down a touch. Take a bit more time over it, looking for the gap rather than just driving hard into the corner. Header. Brent Jones is the way back there. McGrath is taking his place while Brent comes back to cover. Well, that's a sign of a good team too. As soon as somebody drops out of position, somebody covers it. And Chattanooga doing a lot of that. If you're in the stadium, you can watch that and see the off the ball play, which is tells you what a good team should be doing. Keeping possession, focusing on finding the gap. There's that great long ball to McGrath there. It's too long from Zero. Bit too much on that one. But Chattanooga really good spot, the one goal lead, and Syracuse not pushing him terribly hard at the moment. give it time to move the ball around. To the 35th minute, we've got about 10 minutes more regulation play to go. Time will bring these two little big brothers and big sisters in. Great ball through Taylor Gray. Can he get a shot in? Oh, it's right across the goal. But I think he was offside anyway. He was. I a little surprise here for Taylor Gray to find the ball at his feet. Like, oh. So, didn't hesitate in taking the shot, but it was offside. So, an offside called for. Syracuse, they get a free kick. We'll see that again because this deflection is good and Cerro pops it through the Gray, but he is behind the defenders and offside. Slides the shot in just past the right post. Referee makes sure they take the free kick from the correct spot where the offence occurred, which is where Taylor was over here on the left side of the goal box. There we go. On top of the 18 yard box. That's more like it. In with the kick. Chattanooga getting that one back. It's bobbling around a bit. Long ball. Trying to find Caleb Jackson. Can't get his head in it. Tries hard, but forced to take Robson. Has time to look up and spread that around. Nagelstadt with a great ball to Jones. Jones has got Cerro inside him. What's Jones going to do? Round the defender. No, the defender falls over and stops the ball. Unusual defending technique, that, to fall down, but it works. Let me teach you that one in soccer school. Syracuse, the chance to come forward. Zach Reynolds trying to feed it into the middle. To McKinley. It's out for a throw on the far side. Taylor Gray off a little bit too much. Matt trickles out for a throw on the far side. Outside the VIP tents. Tricking out. Checking the throw on the far side. Shocker there from Chattanooga. Nagelstadt now gets it. He's got pressure on him. Syracuse get the ball back and the lay back for Robinson and goal. And Syracuse going to get the pass to connect with the way back to McKinley in the Chattanooga goal. Call it a status quo point in the game. Both teams just cancelling out each other right now. Chattanooga looking for those long balls. That's not a great one to Brett Jones. The difference here being really that Chattanooga's long balls are connecting and Syracuse's ones are not. Brett Jones not happy about the offside call from the referee and the linesman, but nevertheless, free kick to Syracuse. Peter Fuller signalling to his team to push up a bit more. Just outside your picture, he's encouraging them to move up a little bit more. Into the 40th minute. Still one up. He's getting pushed. Love that ball sneaked through, and there it is. Through McKinley's legs, I think. Number seven, Caleb Jackson. Sneaks in an equaliser. In the 40th minute, one apiece. And the game settled down, and there I was wrong. It's out of nowhere, a great goal. That's a lovely feed ball right behind the defenders and nutmegs the keeper. Kind of goal Caleb Jackson used to score for fun for Chattanooga when he was here. So one apiece into half time. This will shake things up a little bit. Oh, Chattanooga looking at the third draw in a row. Plenty of time to go, but who knows? Maybe they'll be stuck with another draw. Quite a good time to score a goal, too. Psychologically, before you go into the locker room, because you're kind of dwelling on that for 15 minutes and come out with your attitude change a little bit sometimes. So, definitely always a good score around the half time mark. Hughes again trying to come forward. Their confidence has now gone up after that. It's the first goal they've scored for almost three games, I think. So they were definitely enjoying that. Ball Minjo cracking into that one on the right wing. He's got support in the middle. He goes to the shot, but Rinton grabs that one no problem. Had Louis opening the box, but he started to take the shot himself, and that was able to gather that one nicely. From ahead. Kingley all the way back there on that one. Jones coming in for the shot. Inside again, a great defensive. McKinley able to push that one away. Not a repeat of the first goal for Chattanooga there, but very close. Chattanooga defensive came back strictly, and Robinson able to take care of that and take the sting out of it. Jones touching it on to Nagelstadt. Back to Jones, lovely. Jones in tons of space. Cerro can't get the shot away. And again, it's just like Carl Newell there with the block. And McKinley looking hard on the defence. But again, Chattanooga looking very threatening. Doesn't able to get that final touch and put the ball in the back of the net, but you've got a feeling it's coming. Chattanooga's build-up play is just excellent. Robinson all the way forward. ball to Jones. Robinson again, possession, Cerro's open, can't get it. Out for the throw in. All the way back to Stripling. Chattanooga's defence all the way up now. Nagelstadt goes down, foul. Yep. Again, dangerous plays about 22 yards out. Moosey giving away the foul there. Four. Charles Janu to equalise here. The stats and Sarah, I think, on that one. No. McGrath and Sarah, free kick team, of course, on that one. They got this lead. Under the last minute of regulation play, a perfect time to get a goal back. Let's see what they do. Rath Cerro chips it. It's too high. And goal kick to Syracuse. Referee sitting in the extra time to be played. It will be 1 minute of extra time, as we haven't had much stoppage at all. So just 1 minute of extra time to play in this half. Clock's at 45 minutes. The referee will keep time on the field. So half time on the way. Foul there, a throw in there. Chattanooga to take the kick quickly. Yeah! Martinez over that one, back in the play. Yeah! He runs out for another throw in the far side of Chattanooga. A few tired legs there, let that go, I think. And referee, I think, is ready to, yep, blow for half time. That's it, folks. One all at half time. The early goal from Chattanooga in the 19th minute from Colin Stripling. Caleb Jackson equalising in the 40th minute. One apiece. Chattanooga FC and Syracuse here at beautiful Finley Stadium on 11 Sports. Come back for the second half in 15 minutes. And in fact, come back before that because I'll be talking to big brothers and big sisters about what they're doing as the pause of the night. And have an interview then. So see you in a few minutes, folks. Welcome back to the second half of Chattanooga FC against Syracuse. They say here in beautiful Finley Stadium in downtown Chattanooga tonight on 11 Sports. Thank you for staying with us. And we'll bring you the second half. It's well poised, one goal apiece. And lots to play for. Both teams obviously keen to get points, with Chattanooga wanting to increase their 6-point lead at the top of the table. Syracuse hoping to get off the bottom, so lots to play for. Here's the stats. Goal apiece, and then shots on goal five shots each. Shots on goal, just slightly one more to Chattanooga, with four shots to three for Syracuse. Six corners to Chattanooga, I told you it's a lot. Three offsides to Chattanooga, showing they're a bit more aggressive. And no yellow cards so far, so all to play for. Don't say team changes just yet. We do have a good sized bench for both teams. Showing five on the bench for Syracuse, and Chattanooga with eight on the bench, I think. No, nine on the bench. So good, strong team. Need reinforcements. Chattanooga got it. One of them's Luke Ferreira, number 11. It's Luke's birthday today. So happy birthday to Luke. Hope he gets some playing time. Maybe a birthday goal. That'd be the best way to celebrate. To their possession focus in the second half, as they've obviously changed size. Chattanooga are playing from right to left in the light blue shirts. Syracuse all yellow. been a warm evening. The sun's gone down. The lights are on. Foul there on Richard Dixon. We have a read of Caleb Jackson. And Caleb Jackson, though he gets a goal, gets the first yellow card of the evening. Nice welcome back to Findlay Stadium for Caleb there. First name to go in the book. So still 82 degrees down the field. It'll feel warmer as the heat bounces off that surface. So well, the sun has gone down, which helps. It's still pretty toasty. And the players will be working hard. We'll see if that makes a difference towards the end of second half. MJ Quack trying to make a break. He's got four defenders. Good long ball there to Jackson. Martinez the interruption. Syracuse getting the header in, but Chatley will clear up in the shape of Collins quickly. Alex McGrath cooling things down there. Chattanooga breaking up the attack nicely. CFC players. Out ahead of him. And again, the crowd shouting for a foul there, but nothing happening. I think I'm seeing a substitution. It's like Hernandez came on the right wing for Stratton. Here he is on the ball now. I'm thinking we got Jaime Hernandez. Some fresh legs out there. Even that normally being a defensive position, it's actually a roving wing that comes up and down the lines. Yeah. So we've added that corner to Chattanooga C on the far side. Another Chick-fil-A corner kick. Hernandez in the mix there with Taylor Gray. Syracuse never sure if Chattanooga were going to play the short or long corner. They're going to send a couple of defenders out there to make sure they aren't second-guessed. Referee, certainly players settle down and stop pushing and shoving, but of course they won't. That's McGrath to Cerro. McGrath gets the ball in, gets the cross in, it's deflected out. Chattanooga with another corner. Chattanooga corner number 8, I do believe. So it's a Chick-fil-A corner. Once again, Syracuse keeping them at bay for now. The long kick. There it goes, straight into the box. Good save from the keeper. Robinson on that one. Into his hands, very solid. Syracuse playing with a little more confidence this half. I'm saying, looking, they had a good team talk and they've got a game plan. We'll see if that sends that way out for the throw-in. Can't be happy about that, but it just crept over the line. But Syracuse, generally the body language is saying they're a bit more confident, and that's nice to see. Chattanooga much the same. Assistant here that Naomi Hernandez actually replaced Brett Jones, number 20, on the wing. Greg Stanton did straight on, so I think he's Lammer's assistant for your observation. Those of you at home wanting to write in, just send it into my postcard, usual address, and I'll deal with it next week. And there is Mr. Spratton indeed, so yeah, thank you for that correction. Again, Chattanooga playing the patient game. Syracuse not actually pressing as hard as they might, but they did initially, and they aren't pressing quite as much. We're 10 minutes into the first half, still one apiece. And Cerro's dropped back a little bit from his midfield role. Now he's bringing it forward. So Taylor Gray and Marcus Nagelstadt up front, closely watched by the Syracuse defence. There's the aforementioned Taylor Gray. And referee's calling a foul on the far side. For Interesting. Okay. I'm sure he's putting his foul on Taylor Gray or. Okay. Discuss that one among yourselves. Not sure what that foul was for. It's a drop ball. To Chattanooga. Okay. Oh, play resumes. To Reddington, can't pick that one up, gets a back pass, but stripling with the ball. Zach Reynolds there trying to get that one, but he goes out for a throw to Chattanooga. Chattanooga back into play. Good long ball there. Hernandez streaking away down the right wing. He's got plenty of space and he's got time. Who's he got the pass to? In it goes, and Syracuse clear it again. Dixon being solid, I mean Dixon, Sean Russell getting that one there, and Moosey as well. And foul. Oh, and a, no, card on Richard Dixon for that. Barely touched him. Good grief. There was much more than two people coming together at the same place, but Richard Dixon goes in the book. It's a yellow for one apiece on yellow cards, one apiece on goals in the 59th minute. Last minute information being passed to Carl Neal from Peter Fuller there. Outside your picture. And back to defend this long free kick. And player up his mark as Nagelstadt. Carl Sewell having to work hard to get that one in play, but does. It's like he's maintaining possession. And down they go again. Really nothing in that at all, but. Free kick from the same spot just about. Not seeing any substitutions lined up. We got to the hour mark, and that's usually when coaches start thinking about substitutions. Syracuse have their players warming up to Chattanooga, but nothing is lined up yet. Good long ball right across. Good header there from Stratton to clear that one clear. Syracuse trying to come forward. Dixon smarter and grabs that one. Three on him, takes a break, gets a touch, he gets fouled. Referee doesn't call that one. Oh, he does. Delayed reaction, but he got that one. Foul on Taylor Gray. Chasing the ball. So he's jumping hoops that away safely towards Cerro Nagelstadt. It's a little high boot. I think the referee didn't like that one. Here was a foul there because that was a very high foot from Moosey. And hang on, no, he's given a free kick. To Syracuse, indicating it was the free kick to Chattanooga. He's changed his mind, so they had the high foot, which was regarded as dangerous play, and they still got the free kick. The fans are not very happy about that in the stadium, as you can probably hear. A little bit confusing. If you're confused at home, don't worry, I am too. So we'll be confused together, do not worry. Good long ball there. Time, take Robertson two on him, loses out, can take get the ball back. Syracuse with a bit more confidence here, trying to make something happen. And now pushed away, Hernandez chases that one down, goes out for a throw to Syracuse on the far side. Tarkus is starting to put the pressure on. Throw on the far side. They're pretty getting in the box. Here we go. Taylor Gray gets it, gets the shot in, and just over the bar. Good shot though there from McKinley. Number 14 trying to get his name on the score sheet like he used to CFC. So again, Syracuse looking a little more dangerous this half. Chattanooga on the back foot a little bit. Team really wanting to go home with a draw and a single point. They'd like to go home with three. For the reasons I said in the first half, Chattanooga would like to get more of a buffer of Michigan Stars. There's a great ball through at Taylor Gray, pushing and pulled down by the defender, by Caio De Silva, and the referee saying that Taylor was doing the pulling, so he's given the foul. Syracuse is away. Taylor Gray not obviously thrilled about that when he was the one being pulled down. Asking the referee to, you know, do the right thing, but the referee thinks the right thing is to give the foul to Syracuse. So it's like Luke Ferreira is getting ready to come on. Trying to get the ball through to Nagelstadt. Cerro comes through, dispossessed, but it goes out. Hernandez now gets the chance to fight for it. And Russell, they haven't got all the way back. I mean, he's sorry, moves all the way back to Russell. Yep, Luke Ferreira getting ready to come on wearing number 9. Traditional 11. So the birthday boy will get some playing time tonight. Cerro coming off, Luke Ferreira coming on for Chattanooga FC in the 66th minute. That's substitution he made, that's the first one of the evening. Substitution sponsored by Martin's Diamonds. Thank you, Martin's Diamonds, for that support. None made by Syracuse just yet. Trying to get the throw on the far side so they can get on the free kick on the far side so they can get the ball there. Spreading the ball, that's a good ball out to Carl Neal. He's got Quack outside him. The inside of it again, back all the way back to the silver. And Moosey. Trey Dixon. Let's see if he can move in positions. Ball deflects through. Oh, McKinley gets that. I think there's a bit of a collision there with Louie, but nobody hurt, so that's good. But coming in a bit hard there. Hang on, referees. Someone down with a knock, with a bit of cramp, so trainers coming on. It'll be a good time to get a water break too for the guys on the field, as it's still pretty toasty down there. Let's see that again. It was interesting with the goalkeeping. Known as an intentional collision, the ball is bouncing around and then Louie is chasing in. Alec grabs it and then, yeah, Louie can't stop and hits him. He simply cannot put the brakes on fast enough. So, and the referee sees that, it's not a foul. So we're taking the water break. Syracuse. Everybody's okay. Right, McKinley the one getting the knock. He might be coming out. He's had a very hard physical game, so he might be getting changed. Let's see. I have to make the tough stuff. I can't think he's hurt. Woods needs to check something out. A little bit. Syracuse do have number 22, Christian Feigelin, waiting to come on. He may sub out for Alec or maybe somebody else. Let's see what they decide to do. Discussion on the sideline. Yep, game's back underway and McKinley comes back on. Chapman's looking to come forward. Here they are, where 20 minutes to play. Be a good time to get back in the game with a goal. And again, Sarky's looking dangerous, no one there to finish the attack. Need to live and breathe again. Syracuse definitely got their tails up and are looking to play more aggressively than they did in the first half. Back with the long ball, Reddington grabs that one, no problem. Alan McKinley's gone down again, looks like cramp. And Taylor Jackson doing his thing on the far side, but I think McKinley's gone down with cramp, so I think he's going to get replaced in it. In the meantime, oh, there's a foul on the far side on Hernandez. Jaime Hernandez getting the knockdown. Substitution. Feigelin coming in. It's like McKinley going off. Slowly. This is going to add quite a bit of extra time on the end of the game, these slow changes. Let's take Robson over the kick. Just All waiting for McKinley to get off the field. Here he goes, finally. Substitution is made. So Raglan 22 comes on. McKinley 14's game is done. Chattanooga back in the play. Here we go. McGrath coming through. He goes down. That's a pretty sloppy tackle. And that's going to get a card from the referee. Chat there among the players. The usual stuff. Number five, Reynolds having a word or two. And even a good place for a shot, 22 yards out from the goal, top of the D just about or thereabouts. Oh, and Michael Gafari comes out as well. Sorry folks, missed that one in the middle of the excitement there. The net and made the net dance, but did not go under the goal, under the crossbar. So goal kick to Syracuse, but very dangerous free kick there. Let's see that again. If you hit that really hard, it just skims over the top of the crossbar. Keeper's near it, and then just touches the net like that. Come the net ripples that way, you think it's gone in, but that one just on the roof. Back in a play. Lots of action here. Foul given. Again against CFC. And Underwood having a word with Taylor Gray. Briefly. On the bench for Chattanooga for the attack. See if they want to bring one of them on. Gray wins the ball and foul called on Gray against Newell. McGrath trying to run into space there for the ball to be flicked on, but nothing happening. But yeah, Rollingwood's got Chris Bermudez and Roddy Green in attack on the bench. We're using them. And we'll see if he decides to bring in fresh legs for that or not. Ferreira gets it away to Nagelstadt. Nagelstadt pushed in the back. Another foul. Game's getting a little bit physical. Makes it more interesting, but don't get any more injuries. Chattanooga spreading the ball wide. McGrath looking up, he's got Stratton. Stratton back to Martinez. To Reddington. Danbar Martinez wins a corner, I think, for Syracuse. No, it's a throw, close to being a corner. in a tight spot, not much of a run-off either. Newell with a cross, Wellington grabs that one and says that was easy. Pushing forward, 75 minutes played, 15 remaining. Still one apiece. Both teams would definitely would like more than 1 point out of this game. Stripling coming forward. Good long ball there to Hernandez. He's got targets in the box. Can he get around the defence? Goes all the way back to Stripling. To Martinez, Chattanooga camping out in Syracuse's half right now. Taylor Gray in the middle. And, oh, and there's it. Looks like a penalty. It is. It's a penalty. Tackled from behind from Lucy and Hernandez. Nagelstadt goes down. Saying Nagelstadt goes down. Chattanooga get a penalty kick in the 78th minute. Syracuse players not happy. Surround the referee and explaining their grievances, but you know that never makes any difference. Here's the replay. Watch this. Nagelstadt goes down. Oh no, it's Russell, not Musi. Sean Russell with the push in the back. Yeah, kind of that in the corner in the penalty box. That's a penalty kick almost every time. So Syracuse players continue to talk to the referee. He's not going to change his mind. They never do. And the referee, I think, is going to get a card out. No? Is he holding a card or the magic spray? He's holding a... No, it's his whistle. It's his whistle. He's also yellow, so it's like he's pulling out a yellow card when he pulls out the whistle. Nagelstadt over the penalty. So he gets back into his scoring ways after missing out in last week's game. Crowd is on their feet making a lot of noise. In the 80th minute, Marcus Nagelstadt against Robinson in goal. Nicely into the right-hand corner, the keeper goes the wrong way. Marcus Nagelstadt making the heart sign and back to his winning streak, his goal-scoring streak. Let's see that again. Very nicely taken penalty kick with the inside of the right foot, stuck it into the corner. Jackson had no chance in that one. Chattanooga are now 2-1 up, 10 minutes to go. Coming up, Chattanooga, Richard Dixon having a word, who's coming on or off? Taylor Gray comes off, Roddy Green comes on. Great to see Roddy Green playing. I know Roddy's been popular with the fans and I know his parents here at all the games in the tailgate, so Mr. and Mrs. Green, your boy's on for the night. Syracuse going for the long ball, trying to make something happen, and out for a goal kick to Chattanooga, well defended on the far side by Kate Robertson. So do Chattanooga sit on the one goal lead, or do they go for another one to give them a two goal lead? As they found out earlier, one goal lead wasn't enough. Syracuse hungry to make something happen. Luke Ferreira gets taken down. And another free kick to Chattanooga. Referee going to check Luke Farrow's okay. So, I think he's okay, just a bit winded. Looks like Michael in making the foul. Yep, Luke's back up and moving. Again, another delay, probably a bit more time added on for this one. That's McGrath over the kick. Back to Stripling, back to Martinez, to McGrath. McGrath makes the turn. Newell pushes it out for the throw-in. Ball bobbling around a bit. Syracuse getting the balance of that one. Now they're trying to make the break. That's a great ball. Caleb Jackson tries to get the shot away, deflected out by Tate Robertson. Well played, sir. Tate Robertson gets his body in the way and good block. It's a Chick-fil-A corner to Syracuse. Syracuse keen to get the pressure on, see if they can make something happen here. Woody back in Chattanooga's 18-yard box. Swings in, deep, swings out for a Chattanooga goal kick. Nice curve on that ball, but just a bit too high for everyone. Alec Brington will kick that back into play momentarily. But Minjay Quack's corner a bit too strong. Went past everyone. Another big foul. Hernandez gets knocked in the back and the referee calls him the train straight away. Hernandez got hit in the head. Hopefully Jaime's okay after that one. Referee's going to talk to Syracuse about that. It's a yellow card for Sean Russell. Second yellow for Syracuse. Hernandez still down. It's nothing too serious. That's a yellow card sponsored by Captain and White McGarvey Eye Care. Got foul vision, go see Captain and White McGarvey to have it fixed. Looks like he's okay up and about. They are taking him off to check him because head injuries have to be treated seriously. Meanwhile, free kick to Chattanooga. Alex McGrath over this one. An indirect free kick. He's got Luke Ferreira unmarked on the far side. And he's not allowed back on. The referee waves him and gets him back on. Long ball from McGrath to Ferreira. That's just too long. Creeps out for a goal kick to Syracuse. Time's ticking away. We have about 4 minutes of regulation time to play, plus stoppage, whichever the referee adds on for all the delays in this second half. Should be quite a few, probably 3 or 4 minutes of extra time, I'd imagine. But the referee will indicate that in a moment. Sankey's got the ball back into play. Pops out for a throw to Chattanooga, which they've not been in a hurry to take, of course. Chasing that one down, kind of sort of pushing it away. Dixon gets it away, trying to find Nagelstadt. Goes right through the box, and then Min Jae Kwak gets a knock in the back from Stripling, and foul given, and a yellow card. Another yellow card for Chattanooga. Two apiece and yellow cards then. The referee wants to that one taken properly. With an indirect free kick from further out, probably not shooting range, but they can do something dangerous from there. Coach Fuller watching carefully. He chipped in the box. Reddington punches it away, catches his own play in the back of the head, but everybody carries on. Ferreira hoofs it out. Syracuse again trying to come forward. Martinez clears it. A wild cross there. And Hernandez is good. Dixon passes it out. Ferreira. Now Chattanooga on the break. Syracuse going to throw on the far side, but Chattanooga going for the fast break. Just not making it happen. Combining a lot on that side. Looking forward to seeing those two play a bit more together in coming matches, I hope. Stripling gets pulled down. Newell again keeps fouling, doesn't get a yellow card to match his shirt, but it may be coming soon if he keeps doing that. So, oh, Stratton pulled down, sorry. And Greg's quite a tall guy, so you've got to be pulling hard to pull him down. He's a big guy. In the last minute of regulation play. Graff over the free kick, Chattanooga pushing up. A lot of space up there in the Syracuse half. Good deep kick. And find Roddy Green. Substitution, Marcus Nagelstadt will leave the field. And we will bring on Nick Spielman. So Nick will come on. Nick is a defender by trade. Looks like he's going to be playing up in Marcus's spot. But Nick is generally defensive. We'll see how he does tonight up there. If he stays in that position or drops back to provide more defensive support for the last few minutes. Green with the throw, deep in. Ferreira trying to get it back. Syracuse going wide to get rid of this. Added time, 4 minutes. As I suggested, there'll be quite a bit, and it's 4 minutes, so we'll keep the clock running here. The referee will keep the time on the field, as always, and we'll have a little bit on the clock here so you can see for yourself how it's going. Chattanooga keeping the pressure on Syracuse. Happy not to rush this. Stratton with the throw. Yeah. and shoving down there. New and Green and yeah, three cut Syracuse for that pushing and shoving down there on the near side. Almost 2 minutes of added time played on so far. Chattanooga hoping to hang on for the 3 points here. Syracuse trying to get something out of this game. We do not want to have three defeats in a row. We're getting that equaliser. I'm really hoping they deserve something more out of this game, but Chattanooga able to throw now. Can Quack get something going? Quack goes down the box, no foul. Ball's out for a Syracuse throw on the far side. Syracuse keeping the screw turned on Chattanooga. Ferreira gets it away. Throws Chattanooga. Goes going and McGrath gets it to Spielman. Trying to set McGrath free in return, but not gonna happen. Chattanooga pushing Syracuse back. Last minute of regulation. Well, the extra time is now being played. And Richard Dixon steals it in midfield. He's got the overlap. Here's Hernandez. Obviously recovered from his knock. Still in play for Syracuse, but pushed back away from the attack zone. We're going to come forward for one more attack in the last 30 seconds. Syracuse trying to find the gap. Chattanooga, nice bit of possession play there, Dixon. Bit of time wasting from Stratton. Deep ball. Can Syracuse make something happen again? Ferreira hoofs it away. Sorry, Green hoofs it away. Back to Carl de Silva. Each attack is repulsed as Syracuse try to come forward. Chattanooga simply push it away, and I think that's it. The referee has noticed there's a bit of a scuffle going on with Martinez and the Syracuse attackers. Alec Rainton trying to separate them all out. Martinez not happy. Oh, and getting a bit of a disagreement here, bit of pushing and shoving. Alec Rankin's trying to keep them all separate. Oh, now there's Chattanooga players. Martinez, McGrath having it set to. McGrath telling him to calm down. Both sides trying to keep their cool here. There is actually a little bit of after the final whistle activity there. But the final whistle's been blown. It's 2-1 the Chattanooga FC. Syracuse players not happy with what the referees were doing. Lord Underwood taking Frankie Martinez away and saying, "Tend to cool down a bit." But 2-1 the victory to Chattanooga over Syracuse. So, it's not three good points on the board there. Just trying to sort out what's going on here with the players, but I think it's all done. The coach is telling them all to go back and leave it and not to do anything stupid. So, players starting to calm down, shake hands, say thanks for the game, lads. 2-1 then, it keeps Chattanooga top of the the nicer East Division, and unfortunately Syracuse remain at the bottom with that result. So if you want to see more soccer here, don't forget the next home game, August 23rd, we have a cup game. But Chattanooga in action next at Flower City Union away on the 16th of August. So the players get a little two-week break. And you can enjoy a little rest and the players recuperate after that. So if you want to come see the game on the 23rd of August, go to cfctix.com, get your reduced price tickets before the game kicks off. And we'd love to have you in the stadium and see all this great action, enjoy the atmosphere. But from the broadcast tonight on 11 Sports, this is me, Simon Neal, saying thanks so much for joining us on July the 4th weekend. I know you've got other things you could be doing this weekend. Thanks for joining us for the soccer. And we will see you back here for the next home game, 23rd of August. So enjoy your 4th. And from me and the production crew here and the camera guys, thanks so much. Here's the highlights. Good night. Have a great weekend.